User experience design is largely about trade-offs. We're typically dealing with multiple user groups with different and often conflicting needs. Creating a single product or service that makes everyone equally happy is rarely possible.
But that's UX today. In the future, with AI, UX design will look very different. Generative AI will enable generative UI.
A generative UI is a user interface that is dynamically generated in real time by artificial intelligence to provide an experience customized to fit the user's needs and context. GenUI will allow for highly personalized, tailor-made interfaces that suit the needs of each individual. Instead of creating a single interface for everyone, we'll be able to create different interfaces for each user group or even each user. This is extreme personalization, taken to a level that was never possible without generative AI.
Now, it's important to note that we're not talking about AI-assisted design, which is already happening on product teams today. With AI-assisted design, designers speed up and improve their existing design processes by integrating generative AI into their existing workflows.
With generative UI, you aren't just using AI to help you create the final design that will be implemented and shown to all users. You'll be using AI to generate custom content, elements, and styles in real time based on the individual user's current action and needs.
Let's explore an example concept for what GenUI might look like in the near future. A user named Alex opens up her Delta Airlines app to book a flight to Chicago for a client visit. She's a frequent flyer with Delta. Alex has dyslexia, which is documented in her user profile. So her personalized Delta app uses a special font, a different color contrast, to make it easier for her. Speaking aloud to the Delta AI agent, Alex requests to see flights to Chicago. Since she hasn't specified a different origin airport, the app assumes she's leaving from her home airport in Miami and begins searching for flight options. As the system pulls up flight options, it also checks for any weather or upcoming events that could impact Alex's trip. A warning message appears on the screen, alerting Alex that there's a major event over those dates that will make her travel more expensive. The system advises Alex to book her flight and hotel as early as possible. Now, the presentation of Alex's flight is entirely determined on her past behavior and preferences. She cares most about cost and travel time, so those are displayed most prominently in her flight results. The results are ranked based on those preferences. The first option in the flight list would fit her needs best, but there's a warning message next to it: no window seats left. Alex prefers a window seat, so she moves on to the next option. Alex never takes red-eye flights, so those are collapsed and placed at the bottom of the list.
This individual example may be plausible without GenUI, but not at scale. Generative UI makes it feasible for Delta to deliver an equally personalized experience to each of its 190 million yearly flyers. So, when will generative UI be a reality? At the time we're filming this, there are teams experimenting with AI-generated content and design, but for the most part, that's AI-assisted design, not having AI create interfaces in real time. For that to become a reality, we're going to need generative AI to be more stable, reliable, and less resource intensive. So we're waiting on some technology improvements. But it's not too early for UX professionals to start imagining what the future of interfaces will be with generative AI.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.